Hey everyone, a very good morning to all of you. Myself, Neha Gupta, your mentor for current affairs. So today we are going to discuss some questions that can be of use for you in your RBI, SEBI and NABARD examination. And as I hope that you all know that SEBI grade A notification is already out. So this is the information for you all that you can get yourself enrolled in this SEBI grade A crash course of 30 days, which tries to basically clear your concepts and help you in getting into the SEBI. So you can just go through this course on our website. Now let's move on to the first question. But before that, for the newcomers, the information is that you can download the PDF of this session on the Telegram channel of ours. The link is in description below. So here we have the first question. Which organization has partnered with United Nations World Food Program for enhancing the effectiveness of Pradhan Mantri Poshan Shakti Nirman Scheme? So first of all, let me inform you all that this is nothing new. It is just the midday meal scheme that was already running in India. So just the renaming of the scheme has been done by the Union Government of India. Okay, so recently an organization that is implementing this midday meal scheme has partnered with United Nations World Food Program. So which organization is this? The Akshay Patra Foundation. Okay, so both of these organizations are going to work for enhancing the effectiveness of the midday meal scheme, which is now named as the Pradhan Mantri Poshan Shakti Nirman Scheme. Okay, now how are they going to do that? They are basically going to ensure the food safety, that means the accessibility and availability of the food to every school, to every child. Then the hygiene and the nutritional quality of school meals will also be assured by these two organizations collaboratively. Okay, apart from this, both of these organizations will also work for the capacity building of the cooks and helpers. Now, both of these organizations will also create a steering committee to discuss and to review the activities under this partnership. So that was all about the scheme, about this news. Now, this scheme is in the news, so I hope that you will prepare it thoroughly. Moving ahead, the second question is, which has become the 102nd signatory country of the International Solar Alliance? So here the right answer is Antigua and Barbuda. Now first I am going to show you the location of this nation. Okay, so here is the Caribbean. As you can see, this is the Caribbean region, and if you zoom it out, then this is the Antigua and Barbuda. So this one is, guys, the Antigua, and this island is Barbuda. Okay, now it has become the 102nd signatory country of ISA. USA also joined ISA, if you remember, some months back, and at that point of time it became the 101st country to join ISA. So here you need to get this thing clarified in your mind that joining ISA means that these countries have just signed the framework treaty of ISA. They have not ratified it. The number of countries that have ratified this treaty is 81. Okay, now I hope that you are already aware of the term what ratification of a treaty means. Basically implementing the provisions of any international treaty within their own country. That is the meaning of ratification. And right now these countries are just in the signatory form. So basically they have just entered into the framework of ISA, but they have not ratified it. They have not implemented the provisions or the protocols of the ISA within their own territories. So that's the distinction that you need to get cleared in your mind. So next fact related to ISA is the Director General of ISA, which is Ajay Mathur. ISA's current president and co-president are India. India is the president, France is the co-president. Can you guys tell me that in which assembly of the ISA were India and France chosen as the president and co-president of ISA? Remember again, that was the latest assembly that of ISA that was held. Okay, the secretariat of ISA is in Gurugram, Haryana. Now India is also planning to extend the line of credit of $10 million to Antigua and Barbuda in the solar energy sector. Now guys, this region, this country basically creates its electricity by using the fossil fuels, and in fossil fuels also the dependence on petroleum is very high. Okay, So in order to reduce this dependence of this country on the fossil fuels, the India is also planning to give a line of credit to this country, but this is just in the planning stage. Do remember this thing, okay? It is just in the planning stage. India has not announced to extend the line of credit to Antigua and Barbuda. Next is that ISA is also joining the 10th Vibrant Gujarat Summit as its partner organization. So this is an additional fact regarding ISA that you should be aware of. Next is, now world's longest metro is in Shanghai province, China, with the opening of driverless lines, line 14 and phase 1 of line 18. Shanghai has the largest metro network in the world with 508 metro stations. The city of Shanghai is China's most populous urban area and the world's most populous city. On which river's bank is the city located? So here guys, if the mood of the examiner is not well, if the mood is very, we can say very bad, then only you can expect such a difficult question in your examination. But yes, in the SEBI notification of 2022, it was mentioned that questions can be asked from easy to difficult level. So you should also be prepared accordingly. So that's why I have put this question here. Now, Shanghai is located on the banks of Yangtze River. Now, why Shanghai is in the news, that I have already told you. Two metro lines have been inaugurated and these are the longest metro lines. Shanghai also has the largest metro network in the world with 508 metro stations. It is located on this river's bank and it is China's most populous urban area as well as one of the most populous cities in the world. Now let's move on to the next question. How many payment banks are the scheduled commercial banks in India? So 2, 4, 3, 5, 6 are in the options. I know that majority of you would be going with 3, because last time when we read about the Paytm Payments Bank, there were 3 payment banks that were categorized as the scheduled commercial payment banks by the RBI. But right now, one more payment bank has been added into the scheduled banks list. So we have the total number of banks as 4. So Airtel Payment Bank, which is the first payment bank of India, has now got the status of a scheduled bank by entering into the second schedule of the RBI Act 1934. The CEO of this bank is Anubrata Biswas. So this is also important. Now the other banks in the scheduled banks list: Fino Payment Bank, India Post Payment Bank, Paytm Payment Bank. And do remember that India Post Payment Bank is the only bank that has 100% government ownership. Now the total, there are 6 payment banks that are operating in India and this is the list of those payment banks. Moving ahead, who is the author of the Sahitya Academy Awards winning the Things to Leave Behind novel? So Namita Gokhale is the right answer. So recently the Sahitya Academy Award for the year 2021 have been announced. So you should be aware of some background related to this news as well. So it is given in 3 categories. First is Sahitya Academy Awards category, that is the main award category. Then we have the Yuva Puraskar category and Bal Sahitya Puraskar category. Now all these 3 categories give the award in a number of languages. Okay, so Sahitya Academy Awards are given in a total of 20 Indian languages and this number also includes English. Sahitya Academy Yuva Puraskar Awards are given in 22 Indian languages, which also includes English. Then Bal Puraskar is also given in 22 Indian languages, including English. So which language award is important for you? So if you are a person who is speaking Telugu, if you are a person who is speaking Assamese, then you should be aware of the awardee from your language also. So right now I have picked just 2 languages. English is the lingua franca, and this is important also because many of the news headlines were covering only the people who have received award in this category. Okay, next is the winners in Hindi. Okay, So let's have a look at the winners. In English, in the Sahitya Academy Awards, The Things to Leave Behind novel by Namita Gokhale has won the award. Then in Hindi, in the same category, Sahitya Academy Awards category, Samrat Ashok, which is a play by Daya Prakash Sinha, has won. Next is the Yuva Puraskar category. In English, a burning novel by Megha Majumdar has won the prize. Then in Hindi, Kissa Kissa Lakhnova, Lakhnau Ke Awami Kisse. It's a short stories collection and it has been written by Himanshu Vajpayee. It has won this award. In English, in the Bal Puraskar category, Amrita Shergill, Rebel with a Paintbrush, biography by Anita Vachrajani. She has won this award. And in Hindi, Natak Natak Mein Vigyan by Devendra Mewari has won the award. Okay, so that was the Sahitya Academy Awards and the number of questions for today's video has ended. Now it's the time for the GK Factory section. So what I have for you in today's session is the alternative investment funds. Now I'm not going into the technicalities of AIFs in India, nor I'm going to tell you the jargons related to AIF, because I know that all of these things are done by many people on YouTube channel already. Okay. So what I'm going to do here is to tell you what AIF mean in actuality in very easy terms. Okay. So I hope that right now you all are aware what a mutual fund is. Mutual funds basically collect the money from different people and investors, and they just create this pool of money and then invest into stocks, into debts, into other corporate bonds of different companies. Okay, so they just keep a mix of portfolio investment. So that's mutual fund. AIF, what does AIF do? It also collects money from investors. It creates a pool of money and then it invests into alternative sources, not in the traditional sources like stocks or debts. So that's the basic idea of alternative investment fund. So from the name itself, alternative investment fund. So the sources of investment here are not the traditional sources like the mutual fund chooses. Okay, so here you can take the example of real estate fund, infrastructure fund, venture capital fund. All of these are the examples of alternative investment funds. They are not the traditional methods of investment that the investors used to invest in. Okay, so only this much is written here. Moving ahead. Now let's talk about the scenario of alternative investment funds in India. So in India, we have three categories of alternative investment funds, category 1, 2 and 3. Out of all these three categories, category 1 is incentivized by the government itself, whereas category 2 and 3 are not eligible for any kind of relaxation from the government. We will come to that, but first, you need to know that which act of SEBI regulates the alternative investment funds in India, because in the recent year, the past year, you must have come across the amendments to this act. Okay, so that's the portion of the current affair that you must have covered when covering your Spotlight magazine. Right now, what we are going to discuss is the rule, the regulation, which regulates the AIFs in India. So it is the SEBI Alternative Investment Funds Regulation 2012. Now, AIFs should be incorporated in India. Obviously, that's the precondition. But yes, they can source money, they can source investment from the foreign investors as well. There are three categories that I have already told you. So, in the category first, we have AIFs which invest in startups, early stage ventures or social ventures or SMEs or infrastructure or other sectors or areas which the government or regulators consider as socially and economically desirable. Therefore, they are incentivized by the government. Now, we have certain examples of category 1 AIFs, venture capital funds, SME funds, social venture funds, infrastructure funds and such other alternative investment funds as may be specified by the SEBI. Okay, so these funds are considered socially desirable, they are considered empowering, therefore the government also gives some kind of relaxation to these funds also. Now let's look at the category 2 funds, which do not fall under category 1 and 3. So that's the entire definition, and let me inform you that all of these statements have been picked from the official PDF of SEBI the FAQs PDF of SEBI. Okay, so this is written in that PDF only, that the AIFs which do not fall in category 1 and 3 are the AIFs of category 2. Now, these AIFs source investment just to fulfill their operational day-to-day requirements and investments permitted under the SEBI Alternative Investment Funds Regulations 2012. So, now guys, you can understand what is the basic purpose of this category 2. Either they can fulfill their operational day-to-day functioning, for that they raise money, and secondly, they do investments as per the SEBI's regulations. Now, this is a very vague term, or we can say very elusive term, but we cannot do anything. It was only mentioned in the SEBI's notification. And as far as this phase 1 or the understanding of the AIFs are concerned, from SEBI examination's point of view also, you need not to go into the details of the category 2 AIFs, the investments that are permitted by SEBI for these kinds of AIFs. That would not be asked from you at any stage of your SEBI journey. Okay. Now, the examples of category 2 AIFs are real estate funds, private equity funds, and funds for the distressed assets, and this is just the some of the examples. Next is the category 3. They are the complex funds. They deploy diverse and complex trading strategies, like your hedge funds, your pipe funds. So these are the examples of category 3 alternative investment funds. I hope that this much is clear to you, and on that note, I would like to end this session for today. Thank you so much guys for watching this video, and if you liked this video, then do not forget to subscribe to the channel, hit the bell notification, and share this video among your friends.